dozen bank branches across the upstate have a new look and a new name. The FDIC took over the branches of Community South Bank and Trust, but officials say bank customers should not be concerned. Customers inside this bank branch on Highway 123 and Easley were greeted with big shiny balloons, marking a big transition here. Over the weekend, the Community South Bank and Trust signs were taken down and Certis Bank signs were put up. Certis Bank took over all six Community South Bank and Trust branches, all located in the upstate, and eliminated three positions after the FDIC says a large amount of commercial real estate and development loans were unable to be repaid.
And as a result, the losses suffered on that part of the portfolio caused their capital to be eroded. And once the bank's capital is gone, then they are technically insolvent.
Literally nothing has changed but the name and the capital structure.
While the name is different, Vice Chairman of Certis Bank, Walter Davis, says that customers will not notice any differences in their bank accounts.
You can access all of your accounts as you've always accessed them. And you can come in and you can access the same services that you've always accessed.
The situation Community South Bank and Trust found itself in is not rare, according to the FDIC. In fact, it was the fifth FDIC-insured institution to fail in the nation just in 2011. Walter Davis wants customers to know that their money is safe.
It's safer than it ever has been. We are a strong financial institution. We plan on staying strong, and we want customers to keep doing business with the same people that they've done business with before.
And in North Carolina, five branches of the Bank of Asheville were closed by the FDIC. Those branches reopened today as branches of First Bank. FDIC officials say that those customers also have no reason to be concerned.